Okay, so we'll shortly explain how you can use the drum pads on the mini lab while you're live looping in Ableton. And the version of Ableton I'm using is Ableton Live Lite 10. So I will explain how you can, while you're live looping, use the drum pads to control the drum. Okay, so to start off, you of course have to select a drum kit. So yeah, I'm gonna go with the Clint West kit today. Okay, so the Minilab comes with 8 presets, and you can access the presets by clicking on Shift. And as you can see, we are currently in the 8th preset, and this is the preset that is customly built for Ableton. So what does that mean? Well, it means that if I these buttons you can use to start the recording of the track. So as you can see, the Clint West kit is armed. Now the drum pads don't work, because if I press these, you can see they select the first and second track and try to start recording. But now you can control the drum with the keys. But yeah, it's of course much nicer to use the drum pads. Okay, so the presets that are not customized are 2 to 7. I've customized the second preset myself, so I'm gonna explain this with the third preset. So in order to use the drum pads, you click on Shift and then on the third preset. And now if I click on the drum pads, you can hear them. So now you can use the drum pad. Okay, but now is what the problem is if I want to start recording this clip, normally I would press this button, but as we are in another preset, we cannot start recording by pressing the third button. Okay, so if we were in the Ableton preset, we just click this track and then you can see it starts recording. But now we can use the presets. So how do we solve this? Well, this can be solved, like a lot of other problems in Ableton, by some custom MIDI mapping. Because the only thing we have to do is, if we are in the third preset, we have to stop and start recording. Like I said, this one doesn't work, but luckily you can assign a MIDI knob yourself to start recording this clip. So how do you do that? You go to MIDI. As you can see, I also did some other MIDI mapping. And that is a part I have explained in the other tutorial video. Okay, so I want to start recording this clip. Well, let's say if I press this knob, I want it to start recording. So you click on the slot you want it to assign to and then click on this. And then you can also see that this knob is assigned to start the recording. Okay, so now, while we are in the third preset, we can start recording and also stop the recording by pressing this button. So I will show you that very shortly now. Okay, so press this button to start recording. And then press it again to stop the recording. And as you can see, yeah, it works. And now you can just shift back to the Ableton preset and you can press this to stop the recording. Okay, so there is one other thing that might be handy to use while using the drum pads, and that is MIDI overdub. And what MIDI overdub does is it makes it possible to add notes to your MIDI clip after you recorded it. So for example, in this drum sample, I only recorded the kick and the snare. You might want to add some hi-hat to the clip. Well, you can do that in Ableton by pressing this button, and then if you play the clip again, you see it turns red. And now you can add the hi-hat. And you see so that it keeps playing the hi-hat. So, well, now I clicked on this button with my mouse, But let's say I want to do this completely with the Minilab, then you have to manually do some custom MIDI mapping. So we're going back to the MIDI part, then click on this button, and well, you can choose which one you want yourself, but for example, by rotating this seventh knob, you are enabling the MIDI. So now what is really handy is if we go to the third preset, you can start the clip by playing this one, then it starts playing, and then rotate the seventh knob, and then you see, oh sorry, it turns red, and now you can add the hi-hat without using the mouse. Okay, so now we'll quickly show you how this works in practice. So first, let's say I have recorded some piano, so we're going to the 8th preset. And now I want to add some drums. So go to the 3rd preset, and then if you own it first, make sure the drum track is active. So arm the track, then go to the 3rd preset, and then if you're ready to start recording, press this button. Second tip that I gave you, rotate this wheel to enable the arrangement overdub, and now you can add other notes, for example the snare. Or a hi-hat. And that is how you